Hello, welcome to another GoJS intermediate tutorial. This video will explain and demonstrate the grid panel, used to display a grid of lines drawn at regular intervals. Using GoJS requires programming in JavaScript and familiarity with HTML and CSS. Additionally, this video assumes you understand the basics of GoJS, which are covered in the GoJS Beginner Videos series. Grid panels are used to display a grid of lines drawn at regular intervals. Most often, a grid is applied to the whole diagram, by defining the diagram.grid property, but a grid panel could also be used in a part definition. When the diagram.grid is set, the grid is effectively infinite in extent. When the diagram.grid is set, you may force dragged parts to be aligned on grid points, and to resize parts according to multiples of the grid cell size. Unlike other kinds of panels, grid panel elements must be shapes. These shapes are solely used to control how the grid lines or grid bars are drawn. For our grid panel demonstrations, we will manipulate the diagram.grid. Let's start by setting my diagram.grid.visible to true. Load the page. We now see the default diagram.grid. Let's add some nodes to the diagram. If we want these nodes to snap to the grid when being dragged and resized, we need to set the isGridSnapEnabled property of the dragging tool and resizing tool to true. Let's also update the grid cell size by setting myDiagram.grid.gridCellSize to a new go.size with height and width both 50. Reload the page. Notice the cells of the grid are now bigger, and if we drag or resize a node, it is dragged or resized in accordance with the grid cells. For simplicity's sake, we will constrain node dragging and resizing to whatever the diagram.grid.gridCellSize is for this video. Set diagram.grid to a grid panel. In the panel's properties object, define the grid cell size property to be a new go.size value of 10 by 10. Remember, grid panel elements must be shapes. These shapes will define the grid lines. Let's give this grid panel two shapes. The first shape represents the horizontal lines of the grid, so its figure is line H. We'll set its stroke property to blue. The second shape represents the vertical lines of the grid, so its figure is line V. Its stroke property is set to green. Reload the page. We see our new grid has 10 by 10 cells with blue horizontal lines and green vertical ones. How did the panel know how often to draw the horizontal and vertical line shapes? It observed the shape.interval property, which is a positive integer that specifies how often to draw this line shape in the grid. Since we did not set the interval property for either shape in our panel, it used the default value, which is 1. So, every 10 pixels, either horizontally or vertically, a line is drawn, since the grid.grid cell size is 10 by 10. Let's set the interval property for our shapes to 5. Let's also add two new shapes, one for horizontal lines and one for vertical lines, and set their stroke to light green and light blue. Do not set their interval property. We'll use the default value of 1. Now, reload the page. Our grid now has light green and light blue lines every cell, and blue and green lines every 5 cells. This can make organization of many parts much clearer. More unique grid appearances are possible too. Let's set the grid.gridCellSize to a go.size value of 50 by 50, and comment out all of our shapes. We'll add a new shape, this time with the bar H figure. Set its fill property, not stroke property, to lime, then explicitly set its height to 50, the same as the grid.gridCellSize height. We'll set its interval property to 2, so this bar is drawn every other cell. Reload the page. We see the grid looks different now. It has a horizontal lime green bar every other cell. Tablecloth-like patterns are easily achievable with a grid panel too. First, set the opacity property of our bar H shape to 0.25. Then duplicate the shape inside the panel, but change its figure to bar V, and change the height property to width. Reload the page. We now see overlapping translucent lime green bars every other cell of the grid. This creates a nice looking tablecloth pattern for our diagram. Note that parts can contain grid panels as well as the diagram as a whole, but shapes in a grid panel must not be rotated or scaled, and events on these shapes will be ignored. If a grid panel should be pickable, its background property must have a non-null value. That's it for this video. To learn more, visit the intro pages on panels and table panels, or read the full documentation on GoJS.net. Head over to GoJS.net to see hundreds of samples, read more about GoJS features on the intro pages, or peruse the full API documentation. Sign up for an unlimited free trial, and you'll get 30 days of developer-to-developer support for free.